The next, hydrophily. Hydrophily means the pollination takes place by water, and the flowers are said to be hydrophilous flowers. The flowers are said to be hydrophilous. Though there is a number of aquatic plants, only a few plants are pollinated by water. The floral envelope of hydrophilous plants are reduced or absent. The floral envelopes in hydrophilous plant are reduced or sometimes absent. Some water plants like Eichornia and water lily are pollinated by either wind or insects. There are two types of hydrophily are there. One is epihydrophily and hypohydrophily. Most of the hydrophilous flowers, the pollen grain possess mucilaginous covering. Mucilaginous means a sticky covering which protect the pollen grains from the wetting. So the hydrophily is classified into two types. One is epihydrophily and hypohydrophily. Epihydrophily means the pollination occur at the water level, and hypohydrophily means the pollination occurs inside the water. So in epihydrophily, the pollination takes place above the water level. In hypohydrophily, the pollination takes place inside the water. The next, you are going to learn a detailed study about epihydrophily. Epihydrophily means the pollination which occurs at the water level. Example for epihydrophily is Vallisneria. You are going to learn a detailed study about the pollination in Vallisneria. The Vallisneria plant is a dioecious plant. Dioecious means both the male and the female plant are separate. It is submerged. The whole plant is present inside the water and rooted on the mud. The female flower is born on a solitary. Solitary means single, and rise on the surface of the water level by means of a coiled stalk at the time of a pollination. A small cup is like depression is formed around the female flower on the surface of the water at the time of a pollination. The male flower is born on the inside the water, and during the time of pollination it get detached out from the parent plant and float freely on the surface of the water. When it comes closer to the female flower and get settled on the depression and contact with the stigma of the female flower, later the coil of the female flower is once again goes back into the water and the fruit is produced. Pistillate flowers are also called as a fertile female flower. Staminate flowers are called as a fertile male flower. So the staminate flowers detach out from the parent and come closer to the pistillate flower, that is female flower. And the pollen grains from this flower stick onto the stigma. And for pollination takes place, the female flower stalk is once again coiled back into the water, and fertilization is occur under the water, and fruit formation is also takes place under the water level. The another type of hydrophily is hypohydrophily. In hypohydrophily, the pollination is occur inside the water. Example for hypohydrophily are Zoster marina and Ceratophyllum. Zoster marina and Ceratophyllum are example for hypohydrophily. Hypohydrophily means the pollination occurs inside the water. The next, biotic agents of pollination. Biotic means the organism which having life are called as a biotic agents. Example for biotic agents are zoophyllae. In zoophyllae, the pollination takes place by animals, and the flowers which are pollinated by zoophyllae are called as zoophyllous flowers. So the animals that brings about pollination may be birds, bats, snails and insects. Among this one, insects are well adapted to bring pollination. The next, ornithophily. Ornithophily means Ornithophily, the pollination which just takes place by birds are called as ornithophily. The flowers which are pollinated by birds are called as ornithophilous flowers. The example for ornithophilous flowers are Erythrina, Bambex, which are pollinated by birds. Hummingbirds, sunbirds, and honey eaters are the some of the birds which regularly visit the flowers and bring about the pollination. The characteristic features of ornithophilous flowers. The ornithophilous flowers are basically larger in size and they are brightly colored to attract the birds. The flowers are naturally tubular or cup-shaped or urn-shaped. The flowers are mostly brightly colored and scarlet, pink, orange, blue and yellow to attract the birds. The flowers are scentless. It does not produce any smell. And they are produces large number of nectars. The pollen and nectars are the rewards for their birds which are visiting the flowers. The floral parts are tough, leathery and withstand the powerful impact of the birds. The floral parts are tough, leathery and withstand the powerful impact of the birds. The flowers are scentless and are produced nectars in larger quantities. Pollen and nectars are the rewards of the birds which approaches the flowers. The characteristic features of ornithophilous flowers are: the flowers are larger in size, the flowers are tubular, cup-shaped or urn-shaped. The flowers are brightly colored, such as red, scarlet, pink, orange, blue, and yellow, to attract the birds. The flowers are mostly scentless and produces nectars in larger quantities. And the pollens and the nectars are the rewards for their birds. The floral parts are mostly tough and leathery to withstand the powerful impact of the birds. The next, chirotirophily. Chirotirophily means the pollination is affected by bats. The bats are the pollinators which causes pollination. The chirotirophily examples are Caehilia africana, Adansonia digitata. Chirotirophily means the pollination which is caused by the help of the birds. The birds' pollinated flowers are called as chirotirophilous flowers. The example for birds pollinated plants are Caehilia africana, Adansonia digitata. The next, malicophily. Malicophily means the pollination which is caused by the slugs or a snail. Here the snail is used as a pollinating agent. Some plants of Ericaceae are pollinated by snails. Plants of Ericaceae are pollinated by snails. Water snails crawling among the limna which pollinate the flowers. Malicophily means the pollination takes place by slugs or the snails. The snails, when they are crawling, it causes the chance of pollination. The next, entomophily. The pollination which takes place by insect are called as entomophily. The pollination which takes place by insect are called as entomophily. The pollination which is affected by ant is called as myrmecophily. The pollination which is affected by ant is called as myrmecophily. The insects that are well adapted to bring up pollination, such are bees, moths, butterflies, wasps and beetles. Of the insect, the bees are the main flower visitor and dominant pollinators. The bees are the dominant pollinators which causes pollination. The insects are the chief pollinating agent. The majority of angiosperms, what is an angiosperm? The angiosperms are flowering plants. The majority of angiosperms are dependent upon the insect for their pollination. Then the next is the characteristic features of entomophilous flower. What is meant by entomophily? the pollination which is caused by insect are called as entomophilous flowers. The main characteristic features of entomophilous flowers are the flowers are generally larger in size. If they are smaller in size, they are aggregate as a dense inflorescence. In what is meant by inflorescence? The inflorescence means a bunch of flower with a common stalk is called as inflorescence. So generally the entomophilous flowers are larger in size. If they are smaller means they are having dense inflorescence, aggregated as a dense inflorescence. Example, Asteraceae flowers. The example for entomophilous flowers are Asteraceae flowers such as chrysanthemum. In this flowers, the pollination takes place by the insect. The flowers are mostly brightly colored to attract the insect. The flowers of this plants are brightly colored to attract the insect. In addition to the floral part, the adjacent part is also very brightly colored to attract the insect. Example is poinsettia and bougainvillea. In bougainvillea, all the floral parts are very brightly colored to attract the birds. Here the bracts are also converted as a floral parts. They are called as petaloid perianth. So the flowers are very brightly colored to attract the insect. The flowers are centered to attract the insect. It produces good smell to attract the insect, and also it produces nectar, more honey to attract the insect. The flowers in which there is no secretion of nectar, the pollen is either consumed as a food. If there is no nectar are present, the pollen itself is used as a food for the approaching pollinator. The honeybees sucks the pollen grains to make their honeys. The pollen and the nectar are the floral rewards of the pollinators. The flowers pollinated by flies and beetles produces foul odor to attract the pollinators. It produces an defensive odor to attract the pollinator. In some flowers, like juicy cells are also present, which are perished and the content of sucked by the insects. The insect, with the help of their antennae, it sucks the edible part of the flower. Because they are juicy in nature. An example for entomophilous flowers are pollination in salvia. In salvia, the type of pollination is leather mechanism. The flower of salvia is pollinated by bees. The flowers are protandrous type. The flowers of the salvia is protandrous type. What is meant by protandrous? The protandrous means here the androecium matures first before the gynoecium. The gynoecium is in an immature condition, whereas the androecium is in a matured condition. So the same flowers cannot pollinated. So the flower is protandrous and the corolla are bilabiate. Bilabiate means it consists of two leaf-like structure with two stamens. How many stamens are present? With two stamens are present in the flower, salvia. A leaver mechanism help in pollination. Each anther has an upper fertile lobe and a lower sterile lobe. What does mean by fertile? Fertile means the stamen which are involved in pollination. Sterile means the stamen unable to pollinate. So the each anther has an upper fertile lobe and a lower sterile lobe is present, which is separated by a connective. A connective which separated the sterile and the fertile anther, which helps the anther to swing freely in the corolla tube. When a bee visits a flower, it sits on the lower lip, which acts as a platform. The lower lip of the flower, it acts as a platform for the bees to approach. It enters the flower to suck the nectar by pushing the head into the corolla. The bees push the head into the corolla. During the entry of the bees into the flower, the body strike against the sterile part. The body strike against the sterile end of the connective, and this makes the fertile parts to stick over the bees. The honey bee sticks the fertile part when it pushes the sterile region. The pollens get deposited at the back of the bee. When the same bee reaches to the another flower, the pollen gets rubbed against the stigma. The pollen from one flower is rubbed against another flower and completes the act of pollination. So in salvia, the pollination takes place by honeybees. The salvia is a bilabiated flower with two stamens. Here the anther having two part, one lobe, one is a fertile lobe in the upper side and the sterile lobe in the lower side. The corolla, the bilabial structure of the corolla is act as a platform to seek the bees. When the bees approaches the flower, the backside of the bee is rubbed with the fertile part of the anther. When it approaches to the another flower, it sticks the pollen grains into the stigma of another flower. By this way, the act of pollination takes place in salvia plant. Some of the another interesting pollination mechanism found in the plants are trap mechanism in Aristolochia, pitfall mechanism in Arum, clip part translator mechanism as Sculpidaceae, and the piston mechanism in Papilionaceae. So some of the mechanism which are present in the pollination are liver mechanism in salvia, trap mechanism in Aristolochia, pitfall mechanism in Arum, clip part translator mechanism in Ascalpidaceae, and the piston mechanism in Papilionaceae. The pollination which takes place by bees are called as melittophily. So melittophily means the pollination which is takes place by bees are called as melittophily. Assignment: write a short note on heterostyly and what is melittophily. Enumerates the characteristic features of anemophilous flower. Explain the pollination of salvia. What is meant by self-sterility or self-incompatibility?